I see that.
começou. The God of this house will do a miracle in your life this morning. He makes a way where there seems to be no way. In your eyes, there is no way. But in the eyes of God, there is a way. This man, may God open a door for you in the name of Jesus. May God open a closed door for you in the name of Jesus. May God bring your enemies down in the name of Jesus.
Last 2 weeks,
the pair, me no abe sinko.
Our Father taught us,
yeah, Baba, yeah.
Become glorious as kingdom citizens.
So today
I am continuing it. So become glorious as kingdom citizens too. And briefly, I will go through what he said. And he stated by saying,
no, can say.
Long life is not an achievement. It is an enablement. That is when you know your assignment on earth.
And
God enabling you to finish whatever he has assigned you to do on earth. That is what is called life. Then he started by teaching us in the kingdom. And point number one, he said connection. You are connected in the earth, or you are in the earth. But you are not connected to this earth. You are born at the hospital in Accra, Asherman. But when you enter into the kingdom, your place of birth doesn't define you. When you enter into the kingdom, you are connected into the kingdom. And he said, American ambassador in Ghana,
American senior Ohano.
He is staying here. He drives here. He sleeps here. He eats here. But he is not connected to Ghana. His connection is in
America.
So also when you enter the kingdom, you are being connected to the kingdom. He said, your connection is to a certain kingdom.
Now,
a particular kingdom. And he said, if it is connected to a particular kingdom or a certain kingdom, then you must be focused on that kingdom. Matthew chapter 6 verse
22.
Let your eye be single. So when you enter into the kingdom, your focus must be in the kingdom. Your focus must be in the principles of the kingdom. Your focus must be in the laws of the kingdom. Your focus must be the king in the kingdom. Your focus must be in the things in the kingdom. Because your connection is not to a country, but your connection is to a kingdom. Point number two, he talk about status. That when you enter the kingdom, at born again, you are being translated from the power of darkness into the kingdom of God. Into the kingdom of his dear son. If you are connected to the King of Kings, then it means that your status changes automatically. And he taught us that the king in our kingdom is the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So on earth, When we talk about the kingdom, then we are talking about the Holy Spirit. So you are connected to the Holy Spirit on earth. Therefore, your status changes. So you don't think like the worldly people. You don't think like Ghanaians. You don't think like your family thinks. Your thinking must change. Everything about you must change. Point number three. Purpose. You have entered into a kingdom. There is a purpose in the kingdom for your life. And the purpose of the kingdom for your life is dominion. Every kingdom is for dominion. Every kingdom which is not dominating is not a kingdom. As long as it is a kingdom, there is a ruler taking dominion over his people, over a territory. So the purpose for you as a Christian in the kingdom of God is for you to take dominion over things, the things on this earth. So you are connected in the kingdom. You are connected to the Holy Spirit to take dominion over the things in this earth. And this is the same dominion that God gave Adam in the garden. And God blessed them and said, be fruitful and multiply. So God gave him the enablement to control. Adam was connected to the kingdom at that time. He was connected to the spirit at that time. So when you are connected to the spirit of God, when you are connected to the kingdom, dominion must be your mentality. Everywhere you get to, you must dominate. So you are here on earth to take dominion over good and bad. You are here to take dominion over money. You are here to take dominion over house. Dominion over lands. And Peter asks his master, what shall we receive after following you? And he said, you will control material things. So you are connected to God. You are connected to the kingdom. For you to take dominion over this earth, the business you are doing as a Christian, you have God. So you must also control the work that you are doing. You have God. You must also control. People go for juju spirit or anything to plant it at their workplace. Why? Because they want to take dominion over that area. So if you are also connected to the kingdom of God, you have the power upon your life that will enable you to take dominion on this earth. So the purpose of you being in the kingdom is to take dominion over things. Number four, opposition. So please, let's correct it. Point number one is connection. Number two, status. Number three is purpose. So number four is opposition. Never think you don't have opposition on earth. As long as you have connected to the kingdom, you have opposition on earth. Something will surely resist you from not
And this same thing
Sadikuya
resisted Adam and Eve.
Adam ni Eve.
After God has released the spirit to enable them to take dominion on earth. So never think that you are connected to God
and
nothing can stop you. Nothing can resist you. Put it in your mind that there are oppositions around your life. Nahum chapter 3 verse 4. Because of the multitude of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcraft that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcraft.
By German foi. Or they or how at your profession. Now, someone did not want to watch it. My bebre, any bebre, I did not be ye at you one.
Well favored harlot.
Or German bunya, when you are dumb,
the mistress of witchcraft.
Be ye himano
that selleth nations.
Ah, adon amayamai
through her whoredoms.
And nam ne be ye so.
And families.
Any nebushi, any abushi aso.
So witchcraft
and be ye
is your opposition in the kingdom.
Awa hindi animun onuni niya or tao.
And what he does is to sell a nation. Is to sell a family. So you are connected to a family. You are also connected to the kingdom. But your connection into the kingdom must dominate the connection to your family. So you must know that you have oppositions in life. Your main opposition in life is witchcraft. And I quote my father. He once said, the day witchcraft ceases on earth, man is free. And he has said, God doesn't do things every day. He does things timely. But for witchcraft, he is always operating. So your opposition in the kingdom is witchcraft. And you must defeat this witchcraft in your family. I didn't hear an amen. Are you ready to defeat the witchcraft in your family?
Yes.
In the kingdom, you must take or have influence. And you can't have influence when somebody is opposing you, when somebody is resisting you. Any form of resistance is cursed this morning.
Amen.
I didn't hear a believing amen.
Amen.
So witchcraft will surely resist your influence. But in the kingdom, your purpose is to take dominion. And by taking dominion, then you must influence whatever you control. Job chapter 5, verse 7. Job chapter 5, verse 7. It is true that you are connected to the kingdom. But look at what Job is saying. Job chapter 5, verse
7.
Yet man is born unto trouble. As the sparks fly upwards. So man is born into troubles. Witchcraft will bring trouble into your life every day. Sufficiency is the evil in the day thereof. That is why witchcraft is working every day to resist earth. So, as you have connected into the kingdom, as you have entered into the kingdom, you have to understand the operations in the kingdom. That there is an opposition in your family. And as long as you come from a family, as long as you come from a tribe, as long as you come from a region, as long as you come from a nation, witchcraft will use the spirit in the nation to fight you. Can even resist you through the spirit in a territory. May God give you the empowerment to overcome those witchcraft. I want to hear a believing amen. So get to know that witchcraft is your enemy.
I have time for.
Then somebody will say,
"Now, Obi Besi say,
how?
Abaya ni say, Ababa say,
will I defeat this witchcraft? Who is resisting me? People say,
I am Gravuka say
that you have God." So things must work for you. In the kingdom of God, it doesn't work like that. Even Jesus said that a man's household shall be his enemies. People in the house of God, witchcraft can manipulate them to even fight you. Ezekiel chapter 11, verse 1. Ezekiel chapter 11, verse 1. Moreover, the Spirit lifted me up and brought me unto the east gate of the Lord's house, which looketh eastward. And behold, at the door of the gate, 25 men, among whom I saw Jazaniah, the son of Azor,
and Pelatia,
the son of Benaiah, princes of the people. Moreover, the Spirit lifted me up and brought me unto the east gate of the Lord's house. So it is not outside the kingdom. Even in the kingdom, some people can be manipulated by witchcraft to fight you. And God opened his eyes to see those who were being manipulated. After today, may God open your eyes to see your enemies. Those who are being manipulated to fight you. So never think that we are in the kingdom, that we are in the house of God, so nobody can fight you. Somebody can fight you right in the house of God. These people are princes in the city. They also come to the house of God to pray, to speak, to worship God, to dance, to listen to the word of God. But they are being manipulated to fight you. And he said, these are the people that I saw that speak evil words, that give evil counsel, that devises mischief. So witchcraft can manipulate anybody to fight you. So in the kingdom, you have to be vigilant. You have to be vigilant. You have to be sober. But you have to be vigilant. You have to know
was a woman
that there is opposition.
Sir, I thank for her.
So, how do you remove or resist also this witchcraft? Mind you, that in the kingdom, you have to get the influence. Proverbs chapter 25, verse 5. Proverbs 25, verse 5. So how are you going to deal with this wicked person? One of them is to also resist him. When he is fighting you,
so no,
you must also fight back.
I was also
one of them is to take him away from you.
So,
mind you, that God's servant has said that the spirit from your family accompanies you every day. The spirit of God is also with you. Proverbs chapter 25, verse 5. Take away the wicked from the kingdom, and his throne shall be established in righteousness. So for your throne to be established in righteousness, the evil person must be removed. The strong person in your family must be removed. The witchcraft in your family must be removed. Never rate the witchcraft in your family more than the power of God. These days, Christians, we lift up witchcraft. We lift up the devil, Satan, more than the power of God. They are Christians. They go to church. But this is what they say. Whatever he is doing, it is not from God. But God has the power to control witchcraft. Take away the wicked from before the king and his throne. So whatever challenge you are going through, which is being manipulated by witchcraft, it is possible for you to take it away. May God help you to take away every nonsense in your life. For your throne to be seen, for a king to be seen, he influences his people through his kingdom. So in your family, for you to show influence, some people must be removed from your life. And Jesus said, anybody who will not let me rule as a king, they should bring that person before me for me to kill that person. So one of them, to defeat the witchcraft, to defeat the strong man, is to remove him from your presence. Remove him around your life. To stop his operations around your life. Before your influence can be seen. It is not everybody in your family that wishes you well, that want the best for you, that want the good for you, but you must take dominion over them. So you must fight them spiritually. Naturally, when you see them, you will surely love with them. Because when a witch is coming, she will not show and tell you that I am a witch. You must remove the wickedness from your presence, from your throne. Then, your throne will be established. Established in righteousness. So because of manipulation, a righteous person can divert
There are so many Christians who are singers, but at night they go and stand at the roadside as prostitutes. Why? Because somebody is afflicting them. Somebody is fighting against their throne. May God grant you the grace to remove opposition from your life. And then lastly, legacy. And God's servant said, if God changes your life, leave a legacy for your descendants. Let those who will come after you see the life you lived on earth. For you, for them, to also be inspired that it is possible also with their lives. And let people see what God has done in your life. May God, give us the grace to understand whatever he has said in the kingdom for us to live by it. In Jesus' name, clap your hands for God.
Amen.